Hello everyone, myself Dr. Avinash Kumar Ojha, and today we learn about central bank and its function. Concept of central bank. A central bank is the apex or supreme body which supervises, controls and regulates functions of all the financial and non-financial institutions of the country and also regulates the money supply in the economy. As supreme body, it occupies the topmost position in the monetary and banking system of the country. It was established on 1st April 1935 under RBI Act 1934 and nationalized with effect from 1st January 1949. On the basis of the RBI Act 1948. Here, given five functions of RBI or central bank. First, bank of issue or currency authority. Second, banker to the government. Third, banker's bank and supervisor. Fourth, custodian of foreign exchange reserve, and fifth and last, controller of money supply. Let me discuss about these functions one by one. First function is bank of issue or currency authority. The RBI has an exclusive monopoly and sole authority to print or issue papers currency by the order of the government, except 1 rupees note and coins. This authority of central bank to issue currencies brings uniformity of note issue in the economy and enables it to control the money creation by commercial banks. All the currencies issued by the central bank, it is monetary liability, as central bank is obliged to back the currency with assets or equal value to enhance the public confidence in paper. Second, banker to the government. The RBI as a banker, agent and advisor to the government. Here, as a banker, RBI accepts deposits of the central government and all the state government and also advances loan to them. Second, as agent, RBI performs agency functions of the government, also as it makes payments and claims or any settlement on behalf of the government. As an advisor, RBI also gives various suggestions and advices to the government on all financial and economic matters. Third function, banker's bank and supervisor. RBI supervises, regulates the activities of all the commercial banks. It also accepts deposits and advance loan to them. The three major functions performed by the RBI for the commercial banks are: first, custodian of cash reserve; second, lender of last resort; and third, clearing houses. The first, custodian of cash reserve, RBI maintains a certain amount of cash reserves of the commercial banks in the form of CRR, as every commercial banks are required to keep a minimum percentage of their total deposits with the RBI. Second, lender of last resort. When the commercial banks fail to meet their financial requirement from all the sources, RBI acts as their last resort or last hope by providing them with necessary finance. Third, clearing house. RBI also acts as a clearing house agent of the commercial banks by settling their payments on behalf of them, as all the commercial banks have their accounts with RBI. Here the fourth function, custodian of foreign exchange reserve. The custodian of foreign exchange reserve, the central bank exercises control over the foreign reserves. To meet the deficit in the balance of payment and to maintain and control the foreign exchange rate in the foreign exchange market. Centralization of foreign exchange transactions with the Reserve Bank serves two objectives. It helps the bank in stabilizing the external value of currencies. Second, it helps in purchasing and pursuing coordinate policy towards the balance of payment situations. Fifth, control of money supply. It is the most important function of RBI. Since RBI has the sole monopoly of issuing currency, thus it plays a major role to control the demand and supply of money in the economy and credit creation done by commercial banks in order to maintain the economic stability. It is also called monetary policy of RBI. There are various measures or instruments to control the money supply and credit creation. These instruments have been classified into two categories. First, quantitative methods and second, qualitative methods. Here, monetary policy instruments. Monetary policy. In the monetary policy, here the two instruments. First, quantitative instruments. In the quantitative instruments are first bank rate, second repo rate, third reverse repo rate, fourth open market operation, and last LRR. In second, qualitative instruments, first margin requirement, second borrowing solution, and third credit rationing. Let me discuss one by one in quantitative instruments. First, bank rate. It refers to the rate at which central bank lends loan to commercial banks for long term. During inflation, when money supply is more in the economy, central bank increases the bank rate, which forces commercial banks to increase their interest rates or lending rates, thus discouraging general public to take loans, resulting in decrease in demand and vice versa. Second, repo rate. It refers to the rate at which central bank lends loan to commercial banks for short term. Repo rate and bank rate are almost similar except the following differences. Repo rate is applicable to short term lending by the central bank and it's governed by the short term interest rate. On the other hand, bank rate is applicable to long term lending by the central bank and it's governed by the long term interest rate. Third, reverse repo rate. It is a rate at which commercial banks lend loans to central bank for short term. This actually means that when commercial banks have excess money with them, the central bank takes the excess money in the form of loans for short term from the commercial bank to maintain the economic stability. At the time of inflation, excess demand, RBI increased the reverse repo rate, making commercial banks to lend more to RBI instead of general public and vice versa. Fourth, open market operation. It refers to buying and selling of government securities to or from general public and commercial banks. At the time of inflation, RBI sells this security to general public and commercial banks, which in turn reduces the purchasing power of the public and banks, resulting in reduction of excess money supply from the economy and vice versa in the case of deflation. Fifth, legal reserve requirement. It refers to the minimum percentage of the total deposit which every commercial bank have to keep in the form of reserves. This ratio of reserve is decided by the RBI. LRR is equal to CRR plus SLR. Cash reserve ratio CRR, it is the minimum percentage of total deposits which commercial banks are required to keep with the central banks. Second, SLR, statutory liquidity ratio, it is the minimum amount of reserve of total deposits which commercial banks are required to keep with themselves. In case of inflation, RBI increases CRR and SLR so that more amount of reserves are kept with banks to decrease their lending capacity to the public. Second, qualitative instruments. In qualitative instruments, here three tools. First, margin requirement. In margin requirement, it is the difference between the amount of loan and the market value of the assets which is kept as mortgage with the bank. During the time of inflation, RBI increases the margin requirement, making it expensive for the general public to take loans, and thereby results in fall in the excess demand in the economy. Second, malversation. It refers to the pressure, persuasion or advice which central banks exercise on the commercial banks regarding their lending policy during inflation and deflation. Third and last, credit rationing. It also refers to selective credit controls exercised on commercial banks, where the RBI controls the flow of money supply in the economy by rationing the loans to the productive sectors or producer or firms. Instead of general public, thereby controlling the unnecessary creation of demand in the economy. I hope all of you enjoying this video. Thank you so much.